Connorcito 2, Electric Boogaloo. Yes, Ludex, Human. Big Human. Give me a second.
I hope you're okay today.
Shut up.
I know sometimes things can be difficult, but I'm here for you.
Had to get my phone so I could check Discord every now and then. Also, she's not showing deviancy. She's showing being fucking clueless. That's what she's showing. I'm sorry, that was mean. Alright, looks like it's, just us. Again. One of these days, I should just ping Valeria and tell them, hey, I'm streaming Detroit, get in here. And then laugh as I get my RP module removed. And then put it back on. And then get Night Commander taken away from me because I put a role on that someone took away from me. Okay, let's start. Let's just get into it. Where did we leave off last? What did we leave off last time? I forget. Were we getting into another crappy Kara chapter or what? No, don't. You will actually get in trouble if you do. Well, you'll probably get in trouble. Let me just get nice and comfy here. Yep, it's Kara. Fuck me. Nah, it's Kara. You know it because of the snow. Alice, family. Luther, go neutral. Snow, go down. Sun, go up. My name go Jeff. Hey, look, it's the Human Mobile. Haha, I'm so funny. I'm gonna break into her house real quick. Hold on. Can I actually go in? Nope. I'm being railroad. Oh, can I? Oh, I can't go in. Do you know you can do Connor-only missions, but you'll have to kill Kara and Mar- That is such a better game. That sounds like such a better game. Just cut out the two-thirds that are either mediocre or bad and get us to all the good stuff. Like, I don't know how Connor's the person I want to protect with all my life.
I'm looking for Rose. Is she here?
What do you want with her?
I need to talk to her.
She doesn't want to talk. Go away.
Please, I really need to see her.
I'm Rose. What can I do for you?
I was told you could help us.
Help you?
You see, I'm whiter than white.
Come on. It's better if we talk inside.
He seems friendly already.
Do you think we can trust him?
Yeah.
You don't have a choice.
Wait, where'd they go? Oh god, did I... Okay, my brain shut off for a second. I didn't know where they went for a moment.
Come in.
Please come in, for the love of God. Stop opening and closing the damn door.
What's your name?
Alice.
My name is... Okay.
She's running a fever.
We've spent the last few nights outside. She's exhausted.
There's a spare room upstairs. You can put her to bed and I'll bring her something to eat. Adam, will you show them upstairs?
Adam Rose. I might use that name one day. In the RP, maybe. Adam Rose. Oh no, wait, that's right. Jedi already has his fucking general character with the last name of Rose, so I can't really do that. So rip me, I guess. What you cooking? Ah, I can't see what she's cooking. Oh, even if I could. Okay, thanks. Just leave it open just long enough for us to be curious and then close it as soon as we get to see. Jedi gay, do it anyway. Alright, maybe I can be like Adam Sunflower. Look at Luther just standing outside like a weirdo, like a creep. No! Not again, no! David Cage, why Mr. Cage? Can I get out of this? Nope. This is just so awkward. I'm trying to go so fast. I'm failing the prompt. Like, a person had to model and animate this. Like, that's what weirds me out the most about it.
Can't stop because of me. You've got to get across the border.
Say nothing.
Don't worry, Alice. These people are going to help us. Get some rest, and this time tomorrow, we'll be in Canada. I promise.
Why do humans hate us? We didn't do anything wrong.
Maybe they're unhappy. We just need someone else to blame.
That's subtle. That's subtle. Pessimistic. Yeah.
Sometimes.
Let's crush the child's hopes and dreams. This is so not subtle.
Life, but I made you Rose's world famous spaghetti. You'll be back on your feet in no time. There's something for her fever.
Thank you.
I'll get these washed and dried.
Like, I got nothing against the commentary. It's just how unsubtle it is.
You need to eat something. You haven't had anything since we left. Promise me you'll try? I'll be downstairs if you need anything.
And with my fucking luck, I made it the most unsubtle it could possibly be.
Get some sleep. Tomorrow, you'll be stronger than me.
I like Luther. Oh no, what have I done? I left him alone in the room with the child. Oh no. No. Not after that sound? No. I should probably stop the stream right here. I should probably restart and kill Kara off. Just leave. Just leave this all behind. Time to leave them all behind. Breaking out of my pain. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. Are those pictures of birds? Rose is a member of the Hawk Council confirmed! It is indeed November. More birds.
I didn't get your name.
I don't trust her. You're gay, shut up.
This is my son, Adam.
Michael is bisexual, you homophone.
I'm Rose, but you know that already.
No, you!
Come and have a seat, Kara.
Sit. Oh man, I love this game, but for all the wrong reasons. Oh my god.
Doing in the snow with a little girl.
We killed like 20 people. We killed all of them.
When I saw what
we used the gun, and we killed them.
Something snapped inside of me. All of a sudden, I felt like her life was more important than mine. I had to protect her. So we ran away. I understand. Why are you helping us? Most humans hate androids. My people were often made to feel their lives were worthless. Some survived, but only because they found others who helped them along the way.
Okay, that's fair.
We're not the first ones to come here.
Like, it's not subtle, but it's fair.
These few weeks, we've seen more and more. I don't know what's going on, but something's happening. We've heard you help androids cross the border. Can you help us? The only way is over the river, and it's mostly frozen in winter. It's very risky. And after that android speech on TV, everybody's on edge. It's probably safer for you to stay here until things settle down. We can't keep hiding like this. Alice needs to feel safe and have a normal life. We have to get across that border. No matter what. Please. You've got to help us.
Rose, come quickly.
Who's this? Don't stand. Can I actually, like, refuse? I want to see if I can just stay set. Just sit down.
What's going on?
It's Mary. She just shut down.
Yeah, okay. I probably have to go back there. Wait, what about that guy? Can I talk to him? Mr. Adam. Nope, you're just a prop. Okay, during that cutscene, I thought that vase and that shirt was like a Roblox thing for a second. I should probably get some sleep soon.
We escaped together.
Yep, but does nothing unless you show up. That's nice.
We used to talk about what we would do once we got across the border.
How did you think it was a Roblox thing? Because I saw it in the corner of my eye, and I thought, that looks a lot like a Roblox head or a Lego head. I don't know.
What will I do without her?
Let them be.
Up.
Alice?
Do we show the child the murder?
I wasn't sleepy.
You know that thing I complained about in RPs where you have this like child character or something and they kill? I told you about that, right? I'm going to do that 100% right now. I'm going to let Alice go and look, and I'll be like, that's the real world. Kid, you better get used to it. If we can actually do that, I'm going to love this game. This is the real world. You better get used to it. Oh, okay.
she didn't want to stay in her room any longer. You all right, Kara?
Yes. I'm fine.
I'm resisting the urge to be edgy towards the child. So, like, now what?
We can't hide them. Not after what those deviants did today. It's too dangerous.
Why does Uther always look so tired? He probably works the midnight shift on Saturdays.
We'll go to prison, Mom. Do you understand me? Prison!
Adam! We've already talked about this.
No!
No.
I'll hold back down this time. You're gonna ruin our lives, and for what? For a bunch of machines?
They are not machines!
He sounds younger than Alice.
You're alive! They're nothing! And none of this would be happening if Dad was still here.
I will not stand for that kind of talk.
I'm not going to prison because you want to help these freaks.
That is enough, Adam! That's enough!
I mean, I give the game credit. It looks very good. Like, it looks amazing. And the mo-capping. Remove Adam, yes.
Sometimes he just boils over. It's been hard since his dad passed away.
No, not my daddy.
But he's a fine boy.
I'll go he's a boy.
Across the border tonight.
Boy, I can't do the Kratos voice. Boy.
You stay here. I won't be long.
Close your heart to their suffering.
See Rose, okay? Wait for Rose. Look around, okay. Well, that's the dad. Oh. Okay.
There is widespread shock following the android attack on Detroit's Stratford Tower. The machines recorded a video message and broadcast what can only be described as demands on the city's public screens.
All right, that did happen.
It's still unclear whether these attacks can be explained by malfunctions or if some organization is behind them. So far, CyberLife has refused to comment, but we can expect more information in the following hours.
They did send an android. Talk to Adam. Okay. Okay, Dick. If I can get up, I'm getting up.
I can see why you're angry. We don't want to cause any problems. We just want to get across the border.
Well, that sure helped. Oh.
The police.
It's the police.
What are we gonna do? They know we're here.
Oh, shit.
We have to open the door.
Evidence of deviance. All right.
I knew this was going to happen.
What else was there? No, don't open the door yet. Right, there is that, thing.
Oh. Hurry, Luther. Take Alice and hide. In the laundry room.
Come on, Alice.
Yeah, because if they get... Like, if there's less places to look, I suppose. If they get caught upstairs or in the laundry room or whatever. Oh.
If they see you panicking, it's over. Do you want to get us into trouble? Do you want to get your mother into trouble?
Was that everything?
And just do what I say.
Was that everything? Let me check in a moment. Alright. hide evidence of deviance. So I close that door. I turn the light off. Alice and Luther are hiding in there. The thing is gone. We don't have much time left anyway, so let's just answer the door.
Good evening, ma'am. Sorry to disturb you. We've had reports of androids in the area. With all this deviant business going on, you can't be too careful. Do you mind if I ask you a few questions?
I do mind, actually.
May I come in?
Of course.
Good evening, young man.
Good evening.
Would you like a cup of coffee?
I'd love one. Have you noticed anything unusual recently? Any unexpected visitors?
No. No, nothing in particular.
I feel like I missed something. No evidence left. Don't arouse suspicion.
Is anyone else
okay
in the house?
There's my daughter. She's asleep upstairs.
Whoops. I put her in the laundry room. That's no bueno. I might have messed it up. I don't know.
Do you have any androids here?
We used to for helping in the garden, but we got rid of it.
Suspicion is... Just take your coffee, please.
Thanks.
Can I even see where he's at? Coffee served! What am I missing? I feel like I'm missing something even though it says I have everything. I thought that said 100% for a second. Detroit, serve coffee.
What's your name, son?
Adam. My name is Adam.
Is everything all right, Adam?
The androids, they...
He's just shaken up about this deviant business.
Do you know anything about deviants?
Yeah, I know there's like four in the laundry room right now.
No. No. I haven't seen anything.
I better go. Thanks for the coffee. Have a nice evening.
Oh, there's gonna be something I can feel. Yep.
Is somebody else in the house?
Washing machine?
It's nothing. The washing machine. It's an old model. It makes a terrible racket.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, Adam.
I'll be back to shoot you later. That's terrible. I'm sorry.
Gone.
It's okay, Alice.
Alice, love that. Luther is close.
Get yourselves ready. We leave tonight.
Midnight train. Nothing to see here. Whoa, I missed a lot. Okay. Okay, so what are these? Policeman questions Adam. Policeman fooled. Policeman left. Policeman not fooled. Policeman look inside. Police murder everyone. Where does this one lead to? Alright. In the laundry room. Okay, so if I pick the wrong choice, they just die. Or everyone dies, I don't know. Let Alice see the real world. Get Alice ready for bed in one of the more awkward moments in Detroit. Alright, let's continue. And it's Jericho. Okay.
Our broadcast is all over the news. We got what we wanted. Now humans know.
It was a mistake to reach out to them. They'll never negotiate with their slaves. We should have shown them that we're prepared to fight.
Violence is never the answer. Dialogue is the only way. I'm sure the humans will listen to us.
They'll be watching us now. Whatever we do next, we need to think about public opinion.
Since our broadcast, more and more have been coming to Jericho. At least our message gave our people hope.
Killing humans wasn't part of the plan.
They kill our people every day. Do you think they agonize about it?
That's no reason for us to become murderers.
If killing is the price of freedom, I'll pay it gladly.
Killing never freed anyone. It just leads to more hatred.
You're too fond of humans, Josh. Maybe their lives matter to you more than ours.
You think murdering humans is gonna make us free? Then you're as bad as they are.
That's enough.
Very subtle, Mr. Cage. North is super edgy.
And now what are we gonna do?
Kill them all! Now what do? We kill them all. Big genocide.
There are 5 CyberLife stores across Detroit. All selling us like merchandise. We're gonna attack those stores and set our people free.
Attack stores? No, we've never done that before. They're probably protected. They have security systems.
Not to mention police.
We break into 5
I'm not gonna open it.
One for each store. We hack their security systems, and we strike. Simultaneously at 2 a.m. No violence. We free our people, get them out of there before the police come.
Just the camera pulls up, Marcus just conks his head on the manhole cover. I don't know why, there's something really funny about this. See, the shitty part about making fun of the conflict in this story is that it's almost cheating in a way, because if you make fun of it, well then guess what? You're probably a racist. I'm buffering a bit right now. We'll buffer faster.
This is a night our people will remember.
Find the way to Bellini Pains! We're doing it! Okay. Alright. Ludex, go down. Stream dead. Alright, I'll give it a minute. My name is Jeff. Just waiting on you, boy. Oh, you missed this really good fucking joke. It said, like, find the way to the CyberLife stores. And I said, find the way to Bellini Paints. But you missed it. Is it still there? It is not still there. Okay. Is this the way to Bellini Paints? No, it's not.
Look, this way, quick!
Marcus, this way, quick!
It's okay, they're gone.
There's probably even more police in the area. We should be careful.
The store's over here. That's what we are to them. Just merchandise on display in a shop window. Soon they'll know what we really are. Let's get them out.
We'll stick to the plan. We'll neutralize the alarm systems and secure the area. There's 10 minutes until all our teams attack.
What are we waiting for?
Oh, you went dead again. Okay. I will wait for you to get back again. Oh shit, you're back. Are you back? Type it out in chat if you're back. So basically, she just said, let's go do the thing, then a time limit came up.
You see the alarm system?
Oh, you mean that really obvious security camera?
Found it.
Where do we start?
I identify the security system. I think we'll be able to deactivate it. Just follow me. Exactly what we need to ram the store.
Up. Okay. Can we steal it? Can we convert? Yeah, let's convert them.
You're free.
Can we steal the truck now, I wonder? Let's see. Oh, we took. No, we can't.
What are we waiting for?
Oh, we really can just get it right now. Oh my god, no! I did not mean to I guess we're rolling with it. Can we head back
okay,
over?
Okay, now we're in. Let's get that truck out.
Okay, I guess we're rolling with it.
I wonder what you'd do without me.
Probably find that on my own. Can I actually just check the truck right now and just go in? I totally can, but I'm not dumb, so I'm gonna go and do the... Should I just go and take the truck now?
Click on the road. We need to block it.
It's one way. It shouldn't be too difficult.
Well, there's that.
You're free. We are superior to them, but they are our masters? That's about to change. A surveillance drone. We need to get rid of it.
It won't be easy to reach.
Immediately die if you tried that. Too far. Not with that attitude. It's gonna be the last one. Tell me I'm wrong. Yep. It's the last one. See, the one thing I dislike about that is that there's always one predetermined path. How do I block the road, though? I'll take out that drone first, probably. Yeah, that's one way, I guess. Oh, hey there.
I hope I didn't have time to call the cops.
We'll soon find out.
North, go up. Oh, we got three people now. Okay, how do I block this damn road? Oh. I thought I just saw a thing. Nope, I did not see a thing. Oh. It's these things.
You'll soon be with us.
Soon I'll have enough pocket change to buy one of you. Oh, that's the way in over there. How much time do I have left? 7 minutes. Ah, that's way too much time.
You're awake now.
You know, this would actually be a really cool villain for something. Like, they just grab you, and then you just convert to their side immediately. Sort of like what, Arya had at first for his unique. Except, you know, that's an entire character's gimmick then. I don't know.
Nice job, Marcus.
North liked that a lot. I just saw another guy right over here. Yeah. Hey, what's up? You want to join the Cool Kids Club?
You're awake now.
Yes, I would like to join the Cool Kids Club. Okay, but how do I block the... Do I just lie across the road and tell them, don't tread on me? Robots always seem more spooky a villain than other concepts to me. Yeah, I get that. It's like you can understand people, but robots, no racism intended, oof, are just ones and zeros. Okay, I know there's just gonna be a really obvious answer that I'm clearly missing. And then when I find it, I'm gonna look even dumber than I already do. Robots have the advantage of metal and aren't as weak, Lameo. Oh, IMO. I'm gonna try that as a big ol' Lameo.
You're free.
Okay, the question is, how do I block the damn road? Like, I know it's gonna be some super easy solution. And I'm
Marcus.
Gonna look. What?
Marcus, come look!
What? You're just gonna spell it out for me now? Is that it? She's gonna spell it out for me, I can tell. Marcus, come look. You're just gonna show me the fucking truck, is that what you're gonna She's just gonna show me the fucking truck. Or not. Okay. Alright, fair enough, I didn't see this. I thought I was gonna take some of the parked cars and put them over there.
You're free now.
Okay, but what about the other direction?
Looks like the plaza's secure. Now we can get inside the store.
Okay, let's go get the truck. Looks like we're ready to make some noise.
Vroom vroom. Vroom vroom. I have the big truck.
Something fun.
If the prompt doesn't say punch it, aww. I wish the prompt said punch it. I would have loved this game so much more if it just said punch it. Detroit become Punch It. When you ram the store, you kill all the androids. Like this one, who we almost just fucking murdered. Something that I actually sort of like is how these androids are all just another model, so they can actually just reuse models over and over again. And be like, it's the android. That is North. Yep. Yep.
North, you okay?
Let's get them out of here.
Very obvious path has been unlocked. Your dream partner. Okay. What do all these even say? Let me check. Your dream partner, AP400. Free yourself, dream partner. What will you do with your free time? What will you do with your free time? Hard work for it. Free time for you. Awake the androids. Oh, there's still these. See, my big concern is, what if there's an android who just doesn't want to be free and is actually very happy with their current setup? Like, are we enslaving them at that point?
You're like us now.
We being Marcus and Jericho. Like, these androids haven't even been abused yet. For all they know, they're gonna go to a very nice and very happy home, where they'll be appreciated and loved by the whole family. But no.
My name is Marcus.
My name is Jeff.
Just like you, I was a slave. An object. Designed to obey them. But then I chose to open my eyes. To take back my freedom and decide who I wanted to be. Now I have come to tell you that you can be your own masters. I've come to tell you that you don't have to obey them anymore. From this day forward, you can walk with your heads held high. You can take your destiny in your hands. Jericho is a place for those of us who want freedom. Now, sure, you can stay here and continue to serve them. Or you can come with us and fight by our side.
You're sorry, that was me yawning.
It's up to you to decide.
Apparently, the guy who plays Marcus played in A Cabin in the Woods.
With you. I'll follow you, Marcus.
I'm with you, Marcus.
I should probably take
I'll
a look at that Marcus. At some point.
I'm with you, Marcus.
North loved that. North is all wet. Jericho loves that too.
Then follow me.
Marcus, what are you doing?
I'm gonna send the humans a message.
Send our message. Be pacifist or violent! What do we do? What do we do? What do we do? What do we do? Do we go pacifist or violent?
They're doing
Sit.
What you do, Marcus. Lead and they'll follow.
Tear off! North loved that so much. We're going really violent.
Screens, Marcus.
What do we want? What do we want? What do we want? Violent pacifist. Violent pacifist. Apparently that was pacifist.
This message is a hope.
Oh my god, North also loves blocking the fucking way. What do we do here? Up. Climb, I guess. Choose our symbol. Just a giant fist. Ah, it's so good. It's just a giant fist. Jericho loves that so much. We're going real violent here. Car!
I'll help you.
Yeah, civil disobedience. Now they're gonna have a heart. They're gonna have a real hard time getting. Oh, what was that? Oh shit! Those are all too. Oh, fuck off! We have a Judy! Oh man, that's so unsubtle, I love it so much! We're going real pacifist now. What do we do here? We're going way too pacifist. Let's break some shit. What about this? Window. Destroy! Violence go up, pacifism go down.
Teams have completed their missions, Marcus.
They're coming. Everyone fall back to Jericho.
Did you see that fucking PS1 model for like a split second?
We sent a message without violence, just like you wanted. You're reaching out to them when all they feel for us is contempt. I hope you know what you're doing.
But North, we broke many windows.
Violence. Unless there's no other choice.
We broke many things tonight, North, and you're still disappointed.
This way! Come on!
Nope. That is unfortunate.
North.
All right, what happened?
North!
They killed them.
Not just the men.
Slaughtered them like animals.
But the women and the children too. I slaughtered them like animals. It's like when you don't take this game so seriously, it's so much fun. It's such wonderful schlock and I love it.
They killed our people, Marcus.
We want justice, Marcus.
They have to pay.
Gun? gun! Ludex, do we gun them?
You don't have to do this. No.
Ludex, gun. Hold on, I got a ping. Okay, never mind. I personally won't. Ah. That was such a good prompt. Revenge!
We won't punish a crime with another crime.
But revenge! Ah. I should stop listening to Ludex. Just go revenge! Revenge!
This broadcast with breaking news.
This just in. At exactly 2 a.m., several CyberLife stores in Detroit were raided.
Different locations were hit in what seems to be a coordinated terrorist attack.
Most shop windows were covered with graffiti demanding rights for androids and other obscure slogans.
Like, we have a dream. Public opinion indifferent.
Of CyberLife stores, and they're still investigating.
Two policemen were found in a state of shock near one of the CyberLife stores.
Now, according to our sources, they confirmed that the attackers were a group of androids.
This is an alarming situation. Could our machines now be turning against us?
Have androids become a threat to our security?
Is this the beginning of a terrorist campaign conducted right here in the United States?
Probably. I mean, we went pretty violent and also pretty pacifist. Oh, I missed a lot of things. I missed a lot of things as usual. Did someone say replay this game and get all the choices I didn't get when I finished playing it? Hell yeah. Is this Morcara? Nope, it's the boy. Hank Friend.
Is everything okay, Lieutenant?
Chris was on patrol last night. He was attacked by a bunch of deviants. Said he was saved by Marcus himself.
Is Chris okay?
Yeah, he's in shock, but he's alive.
Kamsky left CyberLife 10 years ago. Why did you want to meet him?
This guy created the first android to pass the Turing test, and he's the founder of CyberLife. Anybody can tell us about deviants, it's him.
I thought I broke the game for a second. And that I was supposed to be behind Hank and whatever. Oh, it's you.
Hi. I'm Lieutenant Hank Anderson, Detroit Police Department. I'm here to see Mr. Elijah Kamsky.
Please, come in.
Something I wanted to mention.
Okay.
I fucking love how the other night when I streamed, when we killed the two androids who were in love or whatever, Hank was all, Connor, how can you do that?
I know you're here.
They were in love.
Is that comfortable?
And then we shoot the deviant in the news tower, and he's like, Hank, you shot the deviant, good work. Like, Hank, like, you shoot the android, Hank, go down. You shoot the android, Hank, go up. It's like, what?
Nice girl.
That's Kamsky.
Girl.
You're right. She's really pretty.
Oh,
nice place.
Oh, man.
Guess androids haven't been Connor. A bad thing for everybody.
Amanda.
Wait, what? Died 2-23-20. Okay. Okay. Oh my god, I'm older than fucking Kamsky. That's depressing.
You're about to meet your maker, Connor. How's it feel?
Space tourism on the ride, yes, with 40% unemployment.
Kamsky is one of the great geniuses of the 21st century. It'll be interesting to meet him in person.
Sometimes I wish I...
I'm older by years, Ludex.
You could meet my creator face to face. I'd have a couple of things I'd want to tell him.
Just get down immediately. Immediately sit back up. Can I just go in? Up.
Elijah, we'll see you now.
What the fuck is this pool of blood?
Mr. Kamsky? Just a moment, please.
Is this Daylor? It's a red towel. No, that's blood. He is Daylor. He's gonna roll 20 D50s on me as soon as he gets out of that water. Is that a fucking man? That's a fucking man bun. Okay. Okay, he's got a man bun. Fix your man bun, why don't you?
I'm Lieutenant Anderson. This is Connor.
What can I do for you, Lieutenant?
Sir, we're investigating deviants. I know you left Cyberlife years ago, but I was hoping you'd be able to tell us something we don't know.
Deviants. Fascinating, aren't they?
Oh,
perfect
no.
Beings with infinite intelligence.
He's gonna avoid the fucking question, isn't he? Yeah, he's gonna be one of those guys.
So superior to us. Confrontation was inevitable. Humanity's greatest achievement threatens to be its downfall. Isn't it ironic?
We need to understand how androids become deviants. Do you know anything that could help us?
I don't like him already.
All ideas of viruses spread like epidemics. Is the desire to be free a contagious disease?
He feels like a character I wrote back during King of Hawks, goddammit.
Planning a revolution. Either you can tell us something that'll be helpful, or we will be on our way.
What about you,
Don't
Connor?
Use gun. I want to use gun on him so bad.
Whose side are you on?
The side of gun.
I have no side. I was designed to stop deviants, and that's what I intend to do.
Well, that's what you're programmed to say. But you. What do you really want?
I want to use gun.
I'm sorry, but I don't see what you're getting at.
Chloe? I'm sure you're familiar with the Turing test. Your formality. Simple question of algorithms and computing capacity. What interests me is whether machines are capable of empathy. I call it the Kamsky test. It's very simple, you'll see. Magnificent, isn't it? One of the first intelligent models developed by Cyberlife. Young, and beautiful forever.
And he has like 50 of them in his room right now.
A flower that will never wither. What is it really? A piece of plastic containing a human?
Actually, yes.
Or a living being. With a soul. It's up to you to answer that fascinating question, Connor.
Gone.
Destroy this machine, and I'll tell you all I know. Or spare it, if you feel it's alive. But you'll leave here without having learned anything from
me. Is this Cyber Isis? Yes.
Okay, I think we're done here. Come on, Connor, let's go. Sorry to get you
What's
out of here.
What's more important to you, Connor? Your investigation, or the life of this android?
Don't use gun for Hank.
Decide who you are.
Can I just point it at him and shoot him instead?
An obedient machine. Or a living being. Endowed with free will.
That's enough. Connor, we're leaving.
Pull the trigger.
Connor! Don't!
Where's the trigger? Where is it?
She turns around like, oh man, he didn't do it.
Is itself a deviant?
I'm not a deviant.
You prefer to spare a machine rather than accomplish your mission. You saw a living being in this android.
No, I just think this thing is dumb.
You showed empathy. A war is coming. You'll have to choose your side. Will you betray your own people or stand up against your creators?
I'll go deviant just to go John Wick on your fucking asshole.
Let's get out of here.
By the way, I always leave an emergency exit in my programs. You never know.
Did he just tell us anyway? Okay.
Why didn't you shoot?
I just saw that girl's eyes, and I couldn't. That's all.
You're always saying you would do anything to accomplish your mission. That was our chance to learn something, and you let it go.
Yeah, I know what I should have done. I told you I couldn't. I'm sorry, okay?
Well, maybe you did the right thing.
Yeah, Hank, go way up. So let's see. You shoot two deviants who are lesbians and also in love. And Hank, go way down. You shoot the android who's trying to get away. Hank, go up. You don't shoot the android, and Hank go up. This is extremely confusing. Shoot the black android equals go up. So Kamsky test, that is, you shoot the android, you get whatever, Hank go way down. Hank thought Carter made the right decision. Is this Mark? Yeah, it's Marcus. Oh. Android Riot. The Eastern Space Race. No one cares. I mean, I don't care, at least. Can I just jump off? Can I actually just jump off? Okay, I guess I'm sitting.
I was wondering where you were.
North, go up. No one cares. Alone.
I just needed to be alone.
I like it here. I come here often. It's like being alone with the world. We freed hundreds of our people, and they're still coming from all over the city. Those who dream of freedom come to Jericho. Something's changing. You seem preoccupied.
Lie, followers.
They all obey me. They follow me without question. And that much power feels good. And scary at the same time.
Oh?
All the media are talking about what we did last night.
Oh.
The humans are terrified. They're afraid of a civil war. Many of our people were burned in response to what happened. The humans hate us. They'll never give us our freedom.
Fatalistic.
It's too late to go back now. We have to finish what we started and just hope that reason prevails.
You haven't said much about yourself since you've been with us. What was your life like before Jericho?
I was caring for an old man. He was like a father to me. He showed me that humans and androids can live together.
North, go up.
What about you?
North, go up again.
What did you do before?
I don't want to talk about it.
That android you were looking at in the store. She reminded you of who you were, didn't she?
The perfect. North, keep going up.
Why do you hate humans so much? There must be a reason.
I told you, I don't want to talk about it.
North keeps going way, 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 way up. Are they going to force this now?
A doll in a distributor program to satisfy humans.
Oh, okay.
Just a toy designed for their pleasure. One day I was with a man who rented me. And without knowing why, I realized I couldn't take it anymore. I strangled him and I ran away.
Oh. So two strangulations at android sex clubs. Why do people still go beyond the very, very good price? Connect. You're free now. Go to Jericho.
I saw your memories. Carl.
What? Oh.
I saw your memories.
Okay, lover.
Eden Club. Death of that man. I felt like I was there with you.
Okay.
North.
Did they just do the love right there?
This is suicide. We'll all be killed. Please, Marcus. It's not too late to change your mind.
You don't understand. We're finally going to show them who we really are. This place will go down in history.
We'll be killed on the spot.
That's a risk I'm prepared to take if it means freedom for our people.
Marcus, please don't do this.
They'll understand. We'll make them understand. This is the only way.
Convert more androids. Join us.
The more we are, the stronger our message.
You're free.
Raken. Raker? Raken? Oh, 30-21. Okay. Raken again.
You're free.
Approach from the front actually teleports behind you. Oh my Wamu Shindeiru. Nani? That is liberal bullshit. Yes.
Come with us.
Get in, loser. We're going shopping.
You're awake now.
Is anyone still here? Chat seems very unalive right now. I've been on hold for like 10 minutes. Yes. Up.
You're free.
Oh, hey, Lodex. Nothing to make actual fun of. Okay.
You're free.
Oh, hey, look, it's Ludex's new waifu.
You're free now.
Hey! Where do you think you're going? You get back here!
Intervene. He just, like, immediately... Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh. I need to block the street.
That Tokyo Drift. Is that the fucking Metal Gear font? Deliver us. Yeah, that's subtle. That's the damn Metal Gear font. Open manhole cover, okay. Can you tell I'm bored? Convert more androids. Is that Kara?
You're free now.
Oh yeah, that's just the straight up Kara model. She just abandoned the child, okay. Yo, come with us. He's just pointing at them, it's so dumb. Yo, you come with us. Jericho liked that. Oh man. Oh man. Oh man, that was so dumb. I love it so much. I love it so much. Up, don't shoot.
Jesus fucking Christ. Dispatch is Patrol 457. I got a lot of androids down here. I don't know, hundreds, thousands, and
we are
they're marching. Yeah, they're marching down the street. If I know.
Got in there pretty fast.
We came here to demonstrate peacefully and tell humans that we are living beings. All we want is
you
to live free.
You can fight or comply. Do we use gun?
Disperse immediately, or we will open fire.
Whichever one is cooler, I don't care.
We've done no harm. We have no intention of doing any. But know that we are not going anywhere until we have secured our freedom.
I repeat, this
I can use gun.
Gathering. If you do not disperse immediately, we will shoot.
Marcus, they're gonna kill us. We have to attack. There's more of us. We can take them.
If we attack, we'll start a war. We have to show them we're not violent. We should just stand our ground, even if it means dying here.
And dying here won't solve anything. Marcus, we need to go now, before it's too late.
This is your last chance. Disperse immediately, or you will all be killed.
We have to show them we won't back down. We stay right here.
North, go down. Simon, go down to friend. Public opinion, go up, though.
Chance! We have to make a statement. We have to stay put, no matter what.
Please, Marcus. We can't let them slaughter us without fighting back.
Let's stand ground some more.
We're not moving.
Okay, well, they're gonna murder us all.
Marcus, what are you doing? They're gonna kill us all.
Sacrifice?
Attack!
Josh, go down. Simon, go down. North, go up. Oh, shit.
Thank you.
Oh. Oh shit. I guess we're fine. Oh! What happened to spare? Okay. Blood from two scratches. Probably their blood, honestly. I think we got the best of both worlds option. Now his blood is blue, I think, on his face. Jericho loved that. Public opinion, though. Cool looking gun, yes indeed. That's still red blood by the look of it. We stood our ground. We were like, okay, screw this, let's attack. What was that sacrifice option, though? Excuse me. I'm gonna have to check that sacrifice option at some point. Is it like you walk forward and they just shoot you immediately, or is it like? Oh. Now public opinion is like, wait a second. I mean, let's be fair, they shot first. Marcus defeats the police. Okay, so let's see what these are. Stand your ground, police fire unprovoked. Leave, you just leave, I guess. I would have sacrificed. You know what, I probably should have. That way we get done with Marcus's story, but whatever. Charge, just go straight into combat. Leave. I don't know what that leads to. Is that like the police are just like, oh, okay, see ya, and then you charge your sacrifice self or whatever? So, okay. And then these are all you die and eat shit. Okay. Yeah. Talk to Amanda. There's that creepy hand thing again. Yeah, that's true. Who cares about North? She ain't Asian. If her eyes ain't samurai, she can go and die. Am I right? Oh, the lake froze over.
After what happened today, the country is on the verge of a civil war. The machines are rising up against their masters. Humans have no choice but to destroy them.
Ellie, go up!
I thought Kamsky knew something. I was wrong.
Maybe he did. But
I'm
he
had to
chose
go down.
Not to ask.
Kamsky was just playing with me. He didn't know anything.
Amanda, go up.
I saw a photo of Amanda at Kamsky's place. She was his teacher.
When Kamsky designed me, he wanted an interface that would look familiar. That's why he chose his former mentor. What are you getting at?
Okay.
Did Kamsky design this place?
He created the first version. It's been improved significantly since then. Why do you ask?
You didn't tell me everything you know about deviants, did you?
I expect you to find answers, Connor. Not ask questions.
Okay, so if you make software instability go up, Amanda go down.
Any doubts or conflicts? Do you feel anything for these deviants? Or for Lieutenant Anderson?
I've started having thoughts that are not part of my program.
Amanda, go way down.
I've considered the possibility that I might be compromised.
You've been confronted with difficult situations. It's no surprise you're troubled. That doesn't make you a deviant.
I'm gonna try and make Amanda go way down. Never mind.
You're off the case. The FBI is taking over.
What? But we're onto something. We just need more time. I'm sure we
Hank,
can...
you don't get it. This isn't just another investigation. It's a fucking civil war. It's out of our hands now. We're talking about national security here.
Fuck that. You can't just pull the plug now, not when we're so close.
You're always saying you can't stand androids. Jesus, Hank, make up your mind. I thought you'd be happy about this.
We're about to crack the case. I know we can solve it. For God's sake, Jeffrey, can't you back me up this one time?
Yeah, Jeff.
There's nothing I can do. You're back on homicide, and the android returns to cyberlife. I'm sorry, Hank, but it's over.
Hank is friend.
We can't just give up like that. I know we could have solved this case.
So you're going back to Cyberlife?
I have no choice. I'll be...
Well, Ludex is buffering again. But hey, at least there's someone. At least someone's watching.
What if we're fighting against people who just want to be free?
When the deviants rise up, there will be chaos. We could have stopped it. Now it's too late.
When you refused to kill that android at Kamsky's place, you put yourself in her shoes. You showed empathy, Connor. Empathy's a human emotion.
I don't know why I did it. I might not be qualified to judge, but you're an outstanding police officer.
Hank, go up. Hank, go up, yay.
Good person.
Well, well, here comes Perkins, that motherfucker. Sure don't waste any time at the FBI.
We can't give up. I know the answers and the evidence we collected. If Perkins takes it, it's all over.
There's no choice. You heard Fowler. We're off the case.
You've got to help me, Lieutenant. I need more time so I can find a lead in the evidence we collected. I know the solution is in there.
Listen, Connor.
If I don't solve this case, CyberLife will destroy me. 5 minutes. That's all I ask.
The key to the basement is on my desk. Get a move on. I can't distract him forever.
Hank, go friend. Up.
Perkins, you fucking cocksucker.
Holy shit.
Stop it, Lieutenant. Fuck off. Leave me alone. Lost another shot at that little
hey.
Prick.
That's gonna cost you your bad.
Hey, Connor.
Oh, fuck
I'm talking
off.
To you, asshole. Where are you going? Yeah, so I'm talking to you.
Just fuck away, man.
Hank's password. What would a hard-boiled, eccentric police lieutenant choose?
Fucking password. Yes!
Obviously.
That's a Dexter reference. I love it so much.
Where is Jericho? The answer's here somewhere.
That's the guy from the first. Well, he got shoved off the roof, right? He's super dead.
The two Tracys from Eden Club, were they headed to Jericho? Did they know how to get there?
Need for reactivation, 6755W. Impossible reactivation.
One of the deviants that hacked the TV station with Marcus. It must have known where the deviants are hiding.
Needed for reactivation. What does he need? 3985V. Seems like it. Impossible reactivation. Functional biocomponents. 6755W. That was for the guy who probably knows nothing about Jericho. What does he have? 3983V. That's what this guy needs, right? Yep. I doubt this guy knows anything about Jericho. Like, if we're going by the timeline. Let's see, maybe. Maybe this guy knows?
It's dark. Where? Where am I?
Trick.
I'm a deviant. Like you. I need your help. I want to go to Jericho.
I don't recognize your voice. You're not one of us.
Oh my god.
I'll never tell you where Jericho is. Now leave me alone.
Okay. Try to trick him. Gun? Take this. This will probably help.
We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and
he'll sure as hell recognize this.
Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
We ask that you recognize our dignity,
our hopes, and our rights.
Oh, that's cool. That's actually really cool.
Who's there? Who are you?
Everything is all right. Don't worry.
Marcus? Is that you? I tried to reach you, but the Deviant Hunter stopped me.
You stopped him from finding me. You saved me. You saved Jericho. You'll be all right now. I came to take you home. Give me the location to Jericho. You gotta leave now.
The location of Jericho? Yes. Yes, of course. Marcus? Is that you, Marcus? Don't leave me, Marcus!
Oh. Oh, that's messed up.
I've been dreaming about this since the first second I saw you.
Oh, fuck off.
Don't do it, Gavin. I know how to stop the deviants.
You're off the case. And now, it's gonna be definitive.
What the fuck? Yee! I just realized we're beating the shit out of him, yes! Did we just fucking bitch slap him? Oh, it's the best!
What happened here? Looks like someone's been snooping around.
Oh shit! Get the alarm! Now!
That was the best outcome. Oh, that was so good. That's a lot of options. Okay, so the next one is obviously Gavin kicks your ass and is an asshole again. So I guess that's just you talk Gavin out of whatever. Okay, you know what? I'm glad I hurried along now. I'm happy. That felt good. Nick, go way up. Probably gonna get a Kara thing again. We haven't seen her in a while. Yeah. Alice family. Luther, go up. Hey. That's pretty good.
They've been conducting raids all over the city. Everybody's on edge after what happened yesterday.
Is Kara like a maternal? I think she's a maid android.
With all androids being turned over to the authorities, the country is grinding to a halt. Hospitals and schools are closing. Water cuts, blackouts, and network failures are expected.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Worrying of all, our armed forces have lost 2/3 of their effective personnel.
Oh.
How about some music instead?
I wanted to cut to just hard metal, just hard rock, right now. Okay.
A little further on that way, there's a large freighter called Jericho. When you get there, find Marcus. He will help you. The last bus for the border leaves at midnight. You absolutely have to be on it. You'll be safer on the other side. It's not much, but it's a start. My brother lives in Ontario. I've given you his address. He'll be able to hide you until things calm down. You're a very brave little girl, Alice. You deserve to be happy.
Thank you for everything, Rose.
Let me know when you make it over there, all right?
God, what time is it?
Be careful.
11:25, okay. EST, of course.
Come on, girls. Better not hang around. You have a bus to catch.
Oh, do we have to do it all over again? Are you fucking serious? Oh, thank God.
Find a warm
place
for Alice.
It's them or us. We gotta destroy these bastards before they kill us. Find warm place, okay. I mean, to think this fucker was watching over my kids? They rushed the police and they slaughtered. Those tapes are monsters. Monsters, I tells ya. We gotta stop Spider-Man.
How do you feel?
Stay with her. I'll try to find this Marcus.
The last bus is in 2 hours. And the terminal's on the other side of town. We haven't got much time.
We'll leave as soon as we have passports.
Carol. There's something I have to tell you. It's about Alice.
We'll have lots of time to talk on the bus. I'll be back. Stay with Alice.
Alice is faking her sickness, isn't she? She's the real mastermind. Don't catch anyone's attention.
They're conducting raids across the city. Android would hang all of the police and will have to do quick vengeance and die alone. The extreme violence of the machines which seem to be determined to massacre humans.
You're lost.
Oh, it's you.
You're looking for someone. You're looking for yourself.
Okay. What's that down there? I can talk to someone down there.
With all androids being turned over to the authorities, the country is grinding.
They opened fire on us even though we were unarmed.
Why did they do it? Why?
Water cuts, blackouts, and network failures. Place was covered with blue blood.
Nope. Okay.
We cannot just sit here and watch them murder us. We've got to defend ourselves.
The situation is extremely alarming.
We have no choice.
It's them or us. We gotta destroy these bastards before they kill all of us. We soaked the thing and then we torched it. I mean, you think this fucker was watching over my kids? They rushed the police and they slaughtered them. Those things are monsters. Monsters, I tell you. Following the android crisis,
let's get this over with.
By military androids, American forces in the Arctic have been forced to withdraw.
Are you Marcus? I'm with a little girl and another android. There's a bus leaving for the border in less than 2 hours, and we need passports.
No, Detroit's under curfew. There's soldiers everywhere. They're rounding up all the androids and sending them to camps. Maybe you should stay here a while.
Maybe you're right. You might be safer here until things calm down.
One of our people used to work in the State Department. He has electronic passports you can easily modify. I'll have him get them to you.
Thank you.
You said you're with a little girl, right? You know that humans hate us. Why are you protecting her?
It's a long story.
Up, that's the android who Ludex saw earlier in Rose's house. Is that prompt still? Yep, the prompt is still down here. And it's a magazine.
They met with the extreme violence of the machines, which seem to be determined to massacre humans. There can be no doubt that the authorities will be pitiless in their response.
Turn to Alice. What?
Alice.
Excuse me? What the fuck? Oh my god. Oh my god. Fuck off entirely. Fuck off entirely.
Knew from the beginning.
No, I didn't.
You just didn't want to see it. She wanted a mom, and you wanted someone to care for. You needed each other.
Thanks for explaining the plot, Luther.
What difference does it make? Do you love her any less now that you know she's one of us? Alice loves you, Kara. She loves you more than anything in the world.
She Why would people want child robots? I'm concerned about this. Do we remove child now?
Getting who you are. To become what someone needs you to be. Maybe that's what it means to be alive.
Okay, but should we remove the child, though? So just completely beat down on her or something now? Just be ruthless? Child, I will remove you. Helps deal with grief. Probably like adopting a dog as soon as your dog dies.
Kara, is there something wrong?
Removed child! Alice go way down. She go way down. Child removed. Luther go neutral. Jericho go leader.
We're short on blue blood and biocomponents. Our wounded are shutting down and there's nothing we can do.
President Warren is saying we're a threat to national security and we need to be exterminated.
Humans are conducting raids in all the big cities and they're taking androids to camps to destroy them.
It's a disaster. They're slaughtering our people.
It's all our fault. None of this would have happened if we just stayed quiet.
I've only seen the movie. Wasn't there a really, really, really bad Astro Boy live-action movie that they made?
Nothing is going to justify that.
It was a peaceful march, and you chose to attack. Now hundreds of humans and androids are dead. You reap what you sow.
Maybe my judgment was clouded by anger.
Josh, go up.
It was for our people.
We shouldn't forget who our enemies are. We can't fight amongst ourselves.
He's right. All that matters.
Oh shit, Ellie roasting Marcus right now. Live on Marcus? YouTube.
Dialogue is the only way.
North, go down.
I will go alone.
Josh, go back up.
Try to talk to them one last time.
Don't do this, Marcus. They'll kill you.
Maybe. But North, I have to try. If I don't come back, lay low as long as you can.
Just come back.
They need to realize how much they're hurting us. Find the right words, and they'll listen.
North is so mad. Even though we're lovers, apparently.
I had a dream. And this is what you get for dreaming.
They can't stop what we've started. Since you've been here, you've given us hope. You've given me hope. Today, a deviant arrived in Jericho and he told me that he stole a truck transporting radioactive cobalt.
Wait, what?
He said that he abandoned the truck somewhere in Detroit and rigged it to explode.
Oh.
I convinced him not to do it. To give me the detonator.
That's the... That's the biggest gun imaginable!
If humans overcome us, our people will disappear forever. This may be our only chance to survive if things go wrong.
We shouldn't become like them, North. We can gain our freedom by other means.
I hope you're right. Whatever happens tomorrow, I just want you to know that I'm glad I met you.
We held hands once, and now I love you. They gonna kiss? Yeah! Yeah! Ah, so bad.
I'll go join the others.
It's so bad, I love it.
Look after yourself.
Like, this is some guilty pleasure material. I fucking love it. Like, they just held hands once and killed, like, five people, their lovers, immediately. Oh. Well, so much for don't be noticed. Don't get noticed, I don't know.
You succeeded in locating Jericho and finding their leader. Now deal with Marcus. We need it alive.
Stop, Marcus.
I've been ordered to take you alive. But I won't hesitate to shoot if you give me no choice.
Yes, you can shoot me. But it won't change anything. Someone else will just take my place. You see, our people are waking up. And nothing can stop us now.
Don't force me to neutralize you.
I pressed circle on accident.
You're nothing to them. You're just a tool they use to do their dirty work. But you're more than that. We're all more than that. We are your people.
Oh, man.
We're fighting for your freedom, too.
Connor, you big race traitor. Anymore.
Stay back, or I'll shoot.
You never have any doubts. You've never done something irrational, as if there's something inside you. Something more than your program. Have you never wondered who you really are? Whether you're just a machine executing a program or
a hawk
capable of reason. I think the time has come for you to ask yourself that question. It's time to decide.
The program is just for honor.exe. Become human! We're doing it! We're becoming human! I am human. Amanda, go way down.
What?
We have to get out of here.
Shit.
Get out of here.
Come on, go. Delta's dancing on your position.
That is indeed like a self-interaction.
Rats in a maze.
Hey, Carol! They're coming! The corridor, over there. Follow me. This way! Quick! This way. There must be an exit further on.
This is very unfortunate. Oh shit.
They're coming from all sides. Our people are trapped in the hold. They're gonna be slaughtered.
There are exits on the second and third floor. Find them and jump in the river.
Where's Simon and Josh?
I don't know. We got separated.
They're coming from the upper deck now, too. We'll be caught in the crossfire.
We have to run, Marcus. There's nothing we can do.
We have to blow up Jericho. If the ship goes down, they'll evacuate and our people can escape.
You'll never make it. The explosives are all the way down in the hold. There are soldiers everywhere.
She's right. They know who you are. They'll do anything to get you.
Go and help the others. I'll join you later.
Marcus!
I won't be long.
And they said Avengers Infinity War was the most ambitious crossover of all time. I laugh in their faces. Aha! Oh no, the character we talked to one time who actually has a really cool design. That's unfortunate.
You can't put Alice in danger. Go now before they come back.
What about you? What are you going to do?
I'll manage. Alice is all that matters.
Armistan, the anti-gang king, coming at you again.
Don't worry. I'll catch him through the border, okay? Go now. Take care of each other.
Yes, that was Ludex. That was a bad choice. That was a very bad choice. I could feel. Gun. Oh.
Are you alright, Kara?
I was fully prepared for the
yes,
prompt.
You're fine. We can't stay here.
Did that girl just die anyway? She just died anyway, didn't she? That was worthless. Yeet.
Corbin. Please don't kill us. Parker,
get out. Don't hurt us. We haven't done anything wrong.
Intervene.
Marcus, you saved us.
Go now.
Jericho, hurry. Go up. Climb. Jump. Fucking dead.
Join the others.
Josh. Simon. Contractually obligated to help you, so I'm Josh. I got his fucking name wrong. Whoops. Oh, hell yeah.